What's up? It's KillerGamer18 here, and I just wanted to go over a couple of specs with you with the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One. You know, there's a lot of things going around right now about both systems. If you guys really want to know my personal system, and you know, this is just personal, or you know, this is just opinion, really. My opinion of what system is going to be better is going to be the PlayStation 4. And I can basically just tell you right now why it's going to be better. It's because it's a lower price, first of all. It's only $5 a month instead of $25, $30 a month. It has a lot more to do than Xbox. Now, Xbox 360 and PS3, Xbox, of course, wins over the PlayStation 3. The PlayStation 3, I really have to say, it's not for me. But when these two systems were revealed at E3 this year, a couple weeks back, the 1st of June, I think it came out, I was really blown away by the PlayStation 4. I did watch the Xbox One reveal at E3, and it was amazing. I mean, when I saw it, it was nice. And then when I watched the PlayStation 4 at E3, it was unreal of how big a difference it's going to be. You know, and you have the little things that matter, just about them that a lot of people are going to really look towards, when they do buy their system. Like, for existence, the RAM, both systems have 8. I mean, this is actually from IGN. This is on IGN's website. This is the specs of the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One. And you can see the Wii U over on the other side. Don't worry about that. But, you know, optical drive, I mean, it's, you know, a lot of it's the same. I mean, the CPU is, of course, different. Well, we're running an X86 AMD Jaguar processor 8-core, and they're running their original Microsoft custom CPU 8-core. I mean, you know, like I said, a little's different. I mean, a lot is different, but it's mainly just the little things that are, like, for instance, the CPU. Or the storage, where, and this is kind of where they do get you, and you know, for all the Xbox people, and you know, I have an Xbox right here, and you know, I'm playing it right now, and I know I'm gonna sit here and talk bad about Xbox, but, you know, like I said, nothing against Xbox, it's just really personal opinion on how I think the systems are gonna go this year, and the storage, I mean, really, if you look at the storage, of how the Xbox 360 runs, is you can actually take the hard drive out. Xbox One, you can't. And, you know, PlayStation comes over and is like, hey, we're going to let you guys take it out. So, you know, that's a little thing that's always nice to have, which is a removable hard drive. Now, like, cloud storage, of course, all of them have. Now, you know, and I think the little things definitely with the mandatory game installs, PlayStation doesn't require that, which is an unbelievable thing because PlayStation 3 does. Now, Xbox One, of course, anybody that plays Xbox 360 knows that you do not have to install any games. You just get on and play them. But with the Xbox One, you do have to install all your games that you play, which is really just a letdown, disappointment kind of thing. You know, I thought Xbox One was going to come back as the best system of the year. No, it's not. I mean, frankly, E3, PlayStation 4 won E3. And that was really, when I heard that was pretty, it's pretty surprising to me. I thought definitely Microsoft was going to win. Now the other thing is, like you see, like the used games, fee, you know, nothing on that. No one on both systems, which is good. You do, now this is just a lot, like you do have the USB live streaming, which is a really, really nice feature on both systems. I'm not going to talk bad about anything, but yeah, that's really nice feature with the live stream. And, you know, with the web connection, I mean, really, they're both Ethernet cables. I mean, you don't get nothing better than that. And Bluetooth. Bluetooth is kind of surprising because I actually don't even know if I do have a PlayStation 3, and I don't even know if that, I think, you know, that does have Bluetooth. Xbox 360, I don't think has it. But I don't know, I'm not going to tell you guys wrong. But Bluetooth, it is coming with the PlayStation 4, 2.1 Bluetooth, and Xbox One isn't coming with Bluetooth. So that means no wireless, headsets at all, basically like that. The AV hooks up are just going to be straight HDMI, which is nice, because HDMI always looks better. Region lock for both systems is a no, which is always nice for people that don't live in the United States. And, you know, this is just a couple features. Like, you're not going to... None of the systems are going to come with a game. I don't know if you guys can see that. Hold on. None of the systems are going to come with a game. Controllers. On the PlayStation 4, we're going to run the DualShock 4 wireless controller. And on the Xbox One, you guys are going to be running the Xbox One controller and the Kinect. Now, quite frankly, anybody that owns a 360, anybody that's bought a 360, I don't care if they bought it when it first came out. I really don't care if they bought it yesterday. But anybody that owns a 360 knows that Microsoft's big with their little headset. You know, it's cheap, but it's always nice to have. It's always nice to just get a little something extra in a package. And, you know, PlayStation 4 came over and was like, hey, we're going to put a wired mono headset in it, which is nice to have. And Xbox One decided not to include a headset in any of the bundles or in any of the systems that anybody buys. So you're not going to get a headset with Xbox. You're now going to get one with PS4, which is really nice. Let me see, the camera. Now, this tells me that basically every single bundle with the Xbox is going to come with the Kinect. Camera-wise with the PlayStation, yeah, I mean, Xbox got over them with that. I mean, they're coming out with the Kinect too. But we're coming out with, I believe, I forgot actually what it's called. I believe it's the sensor. It's the PlayStation Eye that they're going to be coming out with the day that PlayStation 4 opens up. And the camera is not included with any of the PlayStation bundles. And I really don't use it, so it's not that bad. I mean, but a lot of people that do use it, I mean, you know, you might have to pay extra $50, $60. But that's not bad if you use it a lot. I mean, that's not that bad. Now, another thing is, you know, just the colors that you see on the bottom of the screen, but that's just black and black. Another of the couple things I want to talk about is just the games that are coming out with it. I know that a lot of the games are like, Battlefield 4 is definitely coming out with it, I believe in November. Actually, I don't even think they have a release date so far on that, but I do believe November. GTA 5 4, or 5. I know a lot of people are waiting for this. I'm even waiting for it, guys. I mean, I psyched up about this game, and, you know, when I heard that it was coming out, I was like, oh, man, it's going to be good. I don't care what system I was going to buy then, but Xbox One, PlayStation 4, it was going to both be good. Well, I found out a couple weeks back that it wasn't even released. There wasn't even a notice about it coming on next-gen console. So for right now, and I know it's going to be sad if for any of you that do not know this yet, GTA 5 will not be coming out for Xbox One or PlayStation 4. Now, that hasn't been, they haven't really said that yet, but they say right now that it's not. They haven't released any information on GTA 5 that's coming out for the PS4 or the Xbox One, which is kind of disappointing because I was really, really looking forward to it. It's coming out in September. I was looking forward to, you know, PlayStation 4 is coming out probably late November, early November. I was really, really looking forward to it. And, to hear about that is kind of disappointing with Rockstar. I would think would already have that game moving. But like I said, I mean, I'm a fan of Rockstar. If I have to wait a couple more weeks or even a month, I will. But they do say, and I want to clear this up for you guys. They did say that any system, or not any system, but, if it does come out, if they do release it for the next-gen consoles, it will at least come out in January or February of 2014 of next year. And that, and like I said, guys, that's really a disappointment. But for any of you guys that have the Xbox 360 or the PS3, I mean, you guys are set there. You know, and I know me and my buddy, we're definitely probably going to get it for the Xbox. I mean, I'm not going to wait a couple more months to play it. You know, I'm just going to buy it. And same thing with Battlefield 4. That's coming out probably November. And, you know, like I said, I'm not going to sit here and say release dates for these systems because they won't even have release dates for them. I just really wanted to do this video, guys, to just clear up some things about this system because I know a lot of things are going on right now. A lot of I can't even say that. Jesus, I'm dumb tonight. But there's been a lot of things going on with these two systems, and I just wanted to clear some of it up, like the little knick-knack things about these two systems that are a little different, but are a little, you know, still to handle with. I mean, you know, the controller's different. I mean, PlayStation 4 is definitely coming back. I mean, they came in E3 and, you know, for, you know, just saying this is, you know, opinion here. You know, I think PlayStation 4 came in at E3 and was like, hey, we screwed up on the PlayStation 3. This is how we're going to make PS4 better. I mean, Xbox One didn't do that. Xbox One, I've been screwed several times by Xbox, Microsoft. They took my money. I've got fraud from them. I mean, it's almost ridiculous. Yeah, I still play with their products because, quite frankly, PS3 sucks. I mean, really. But, you know, and I'm not going to sit here and talk bad about Microsoft. Microsoft does have some things that are better than PlayStation. I mean, if you really want to get into it, I mean, the social with PlayStation 3 and Xbox is amazing. I mean, the 360 beats PlayStation 3 by a lot with the social. But, you know, you see PlayStation 4 coming back with the social like never before. They're definitely bringing in, you know, with anybody that owns the PlayStation Vita, it's going to be really good for. You know, and I actually had, and for anybody that's been subscribed to my channel for a little bit, know that I got the PlayStation Vita and I actually sold it, actually traded it into GameStop. I'm kind of sad that I did that now, hearing that the PlayStation 4 is going to be definitely compatible with the PS Vita. So I'm kind of sad there, but other than that, guys, I mean, really, I just want to do this video to see, you know, tell you guys a lot about the systems or whatnot. But, you know, that's about it for me. And, you know, any of you Watch Dogs fans, I know that's coming out. They haven't released a date for it yet, but that's going to be coming out here pretty soon. You know, and, you know, like that, guys. But, you know, like I said, opinion, I'm not here to rat about Microsoft or PlayStation or anything. So any of you guys, please don't get defensive with me or anything, you know. Just saying, this is personal opinion. So all right, guys. Well, this is KillerGamer18 here, and I actually just want to show you my new Watch Dogs poster. Pre-order that baby. So, all right, guys.